Let's see if they are crunchy. Aspetta.
Adesso il pollo, eccolo qua.
Oh, the chicken, oh my god. Hi and welcome to
Vincenzo's Play.
Yay, with Nonna's Plate. Ciao Nonna. Wow. Nonna's Kitchen e Giulia, my cousin Giulia. Today is an important day because we're learning how to make roast chicken the Italian way, of course served with potatoes. It's an important dish that Nonna used to serve to the family on Sunday lunch. Hey Giulia, remember?
Yeah.
Huh? The Sunday
every
lunch.
Sunday lunch. We eat chicken together with the family.
Used to bring all of us together. The smell in the building, huh, Nonna?
Amazing.
Nonna, cosa ti piace del pollo con le patate?
La fragranza del pollo, la generosità è tutto.
I said to Nonna, what do you ask about roasted chicken with potatoes? The smell, the fragrance, how moist it is. Okay, facci vedere come si fa, Nonna. Show us how to make roasted chicken with potatoes. Hey, Giulia.
The best chicken with potatoes. Nonna style.
Yeah. And we can continue this family tradition.
Yeah,
hey, Giulia.
Of course.
Let's do it. Okay, so how do we make the best roasted chicken with potatoes? First, you need Nonna. Second, you need a good chicken. And here we have a fantastic organic chicken from Nonna Sister Farm. Ok Nonna, allora cosa abbiamo qui?
Allora,
non dici?
Qua è il pollo, adesso iniziamo con il coltello, le forbici, io ci adopero questo qua.
So Nonna is cutting the pieces of chicken. Perché ti preferisci tagliare il pollo anziché cucinarlo intero, Nonna?
Perché è più comodo poi quando si mangia che è cucinato, quello già pronto, prende pezzi e pezzi e si mangia.
Ok. So Nonna prefers to cook the chicken in pieces because once it's cooked it's ready to eat. Instead of cooking the whole chicken and then you have to cut it later on. This
ecco.
Way it's easier.
Coscio? Come si chiama?
That's the drumstick.
Mettiamo qua.
And now you cut the chicken into pieces. It's a nice big chicken as you can see. Look at the color. There's nothing more organic than this. Ecco qui.
Adesso questo è troppo grande, lo rifacciamo.
Nonna said this is a big piece,
così.
So we cut it in half.
Perché è un po' troppo grande questo, un pezzone non va bene.
And she said don't make pieces too big.
Invece avevo quello della carne, mi si è rotto e non l'ho più ricomprato.
Nonna said I used to have a knife for the meat, but it's broken. So you basically get a whole chicken. We are talking about our organic chicken, which is big. It eats well, so it grows big. And you cut it into small pieces so everyone can have a piece. My favorite part of the chicken is the drumstick. What's your favorite part? Suzanne, what's your favorite?
Mine's the drumstick too, that's why we fight over it.
We like to fight over the drumstick. Nonna preferred the wing, but also the drumstick. Perfetto.
Da posto.
Da posto. Perfetto.
Così. Adesso,
okay. adesso che si fa?
Adesso now, lo laviamo, adesso lo vado a lavare.
Nonna wash the chicken properly. Wash it properly, look. Okay, look at the blood coming out there, see? Quindi non rovini i sapori lavando l'altro pollo.
No, il pollo si deve sempre
lavare. Don't remove the flavors of the chicken by doing this. So we're gonna add the flavors soon. E adesso?
Adesso prendiamo il sale, io faccio a occhio.
La nonna puts the salt everywhere and she feels it, she doesn't know how much salt.
Non
she
è che mi regola così.
Just 2 teaspoons of salt, not much. It is important you spread salt all over the chicken so you give the flavor. Ti piace il sale, nonna?
Normale.
Now what you do, you get the chicken, okay, get a large tray.
Si mette così.
Turn your look and position the chicken. Just like that. Oh yeah. Lasciamo un po' di spazio tra l'uno e l'altro, nonna?
No, questo dopo come si cucina si ritira.
So nonna said put them next to each other tight because as you cook them
questo si cucina
it
si
will shrink. So the space will be created. Put everything in order. Oh yeah. Okay? Perfect. This is the moment where the magic begins.
Allora adesso mettiamo l'aglio.
Now you put the
per il pollo ci vuole l'aglio intero così, senza togliere la buccia.
Nonna uses the garlic and she doesn't remove the skin.
Si toglie solo la pellicina fuori, questa qua.
She just removes a little bit of skin. Mm-hmm. And that's what she uses. E rosmarino anche.
Sì.
We have rosemary.
Si mette il rosmarino.
Okay, you put the rosemary underneath, on top.
Allora, l'aglio, il rosmarino, il vino.
Quanto vino metti?
Poco. Quanto basta? Poco. Così.
About a glass of white wine.
Poi metto l'olio.
And then, of course, homemade extra virgin olive oil. Be very generous.
Ecco. Guarda là.
Yeah.
Che bel piatto.
Nonna said, look at this. Look how beautiful it is.
Prima di metterlo in forno, lo faccio raffare un po' sopra il fornello. Ecco, fornello acceso, mettiamo sta qua.
So nonna before put it in the oven.
Un pochino che si
she cooks the meat on the stove. Mm. On the stove. Just for a couple of minutes. Per 10 minuti nonna.
Sì.
About 10 minutes so that you
poi si inforna il tempo di cottura che ci vuole.
After about 5 minutes turn them around so you braise, you say braise both sides. Now it's time to peel the potatoes for the roasted chicken with potatoes.
Ecco, patate. Facciamo così.
So nonna is cutting the potatoes into small cubes and then she's putting them in water. The reason why the potatoes are in the water is so they don't get dark.
Si può fare grande, si può fare piccolo, questo è a piacere come lo vogliono.
You can do the potatoes big,
si può fare così intero.
You can make it large like this, like wedges. It's up to you.
Secondo come piace, a me piace così.
It's your taste. Nonna likes it like this. If you like them bigger, make them bigger.
Un altro poco.
Wash them a little bit more. Now you put salt to give the flavor. And nonna will say again, you have to fill it. I would say about 2 teaspoons. Make sure it is now water. The little potatoes. Just a little bit more salt.
Mettiamo nella teglia.
Put it in the tray. And now we need to add the flavors to the potatoes.
Mettiamo rosmarino.
Add rosemary. Rosemary gives the nice flavor. Then again you put garlic.
L'aglio vestito.
You keep the skin on, you only remove the bottom part. Nonna makes a little cut here in the garlic so the flavor comes out.
L'aglio vestito si dice, non tolto la prima buccia.
Dressed up garlic.
Non tolto, così.
And last but not least.
Mettiamo l'olio.
Extra virgin olive oil. Of course it's homemade olive oil. Yes. Yum. Mm. Be generous. So look how much the meat cooked. In about 10-15 minutes at high heat, the meat is nice and brown, ready to go in the oven. Look how beautiful it is. The chicken in the oven. Yum. Ora quanto tempo aspettiamo, nonna?
Tempo di cottura, un'oretta.
Una sede, one hour and a half, and it is ready, maybe 2 hours. Mm. So this is Nonna's trick, this is Nonna's technique for
bollitura,
making
così
great potatoes, non roasted potatoes.
Non diventa molli.
What she does is she cooks them a little bit on the cooktop, so they don't become too soft, so they get crunchy. It creates water, so when that water, that liquid evaporates, from the cooktop, nonna puts it in the oven. That's how she understands when it's time to put them in the oven. See, it creates water. This technique is the technique that you need to use if you want nice, crunchy potatoes. Non is always right. She doesn't know if she does the right thing or not. I think she always does the right thing. Good technique. I've never used this technique and I can't wait to use it. Also, Nonna is checking the chicken at the same time. Mm. Looks like it's cooking. Sta cucinando, nonna?
Sì, è quasi pronto.
Nonna said the chicken is almost ready. Mm. Sei felice del colore?
Sì.
Nonna is happy with the color.
Che
and see the water disappearing. Look.
Mm.
The steam.
Senti che profumo.
And the flavor from the rosemary. Che profumino, nonna. Mm. The flavor from the rosemary is coming out. So this is what Nonna does. Nonna removes the chicken from the oven. Looks nice and ready. And places the potatoes in the oven.
Adesso mettiamo...
For about half an hour. And you don't want to touch the potatoes when they are in the oven. Or they can break.
Quando c'è questo colore è già cotto.
Okay. So she said, when you see this, it's already cooked. Ah, ora lo finiamo un altro po' nel forno però, per me servirlo, vero?
Sì, ecco, le patate, guarda quando sono belle.
Wow!
Guarda che amore. Sono rovinate per niente.
Nonna, sei fantastica.
Grazie.
Oh my gosh, if only you could smell this. And then Nonna puts the chicken in the oven just a little bit longer, just for a few minutes. Un paio di minuti, nonna.
Che cosa?
Il bollo.
Sì.
So then she can serve it nice and hot while the potatoes cool down.
Guarda che belli,
so she can serve it together.
Let's see if they are crunchy. Aspetta. Mmm.
Croccantissimo.
Crunchy. Croccantissimo, bravo. Un pollo. Facciamo il pollo, vai. Mamma mia. Wow.
Adesso il pollo, eccolo qua.
Non the chicken, oh my god. Pranzo è servito, pranzo è servito, Giugi.
Grazie.
Eccolo qui.
Che profumi,
Facciamo proprio alla contadina, con tutto il vassoio che ci abbiamo cucinato.
That's the farm style. You serve it on the same tray you cooked. Mamma mia, wow. Mm. How is it? Buono, nonna?
Buonissimo.
Ti piace? Le patate come sono?
Guardi quante sono belle le mie patate, non se ne sono ammollate manco una.
No, se Luca ha visto come potete usare. They are beautiful, they are crunchy.
Proprio croccante, guarda là.
Allora, guys, thank you for watching this episode.
Andate al ristorante che mi mangiate così.
Go to the restaurant, go. You can dream of eating a chicken like this. And the potato so perfect. Go to the restaurant. We enjoy nonna's food. If you want to eat a chicken, an amazing chicken, Megan, following Nonna steps, and Julia, we can continue this family tradition. So, Nonna, grazie, grazie mille. Now, thank you so much for watching this episode. We will see you in the next Vincenzo's Plate video recipe. E ora si mangia! Vincenzo's Plate!
Buon appetito a tutti!
Buon appetito! Nonna, all she cares about is eating. Vai, buon appetito!
Grazie nonna!
Grazie a voi!
Prego!